Hello, fellow music lovers and analysts. I am Kylie Richardson, and I will present to you my analysis, interpretation, and appreciation of Frank Zappa's You Never Know Who Your Friends Are. But first, a little background on the composer. Frank Zappa was practically born an avant-garde artist. From his youth, he was taking elements of music he liked and fusing them with other styles. He taught himself to play many instruments as a child, but focused on guitar. He was heavily influenced by rhythm and blues, 50s rock and roll, Igor Stravinsky, and Edgard Varese, the last of which being his favorite. They were all part of his collection. These would later emerge in his compositions, which feature works from the genres of jazz, rock, pop, electronic, and orchestral music, just to name a few. He formed a band in high school, and by his senior year, he was composing and arranging innovative pieces for his school orchestra. His music career began to take off when he started recording in 1960 at the age of 19, after having dropped out of his college theory courses. He soon formed a new band who would become the Mothers, but when they contracted with MGM, had to become the Mothers of Invention due to their not so good reputation. This band would undergo multiple changes through the years to the point of hardly being a band, but would serve as a platform for introducing his radical musical inventions and free speech activism to the public. Though at times accused of excessive scatology in his musical works and criticized for lewd lyrics, even arrested briefly for creating sketchy auditory material for an undercover police officer, Frank Zappa can be accredited for his bold lyrics and stylistic innovations. He created dozens of full records of tracks, plus other works that were never marketed, emerging from the vault over time as his family and others uncovered it. In all of these works, there have been an eclectic mix of symphonic works, fusions of rhythm and blues, rock and jazz, plus a number of other compositions exhibiting his political and religious views, and outstanding improvisational skills on the guitar. Among these was even a bicycle concerto he played on Steve Allen's TV show. Needless to say, he was a man inspired by the influences and the world around him. I've chosen a song not so politically or morally forceful as some of Frank Zappa's other work, but one that is incredibly colorful in melody and textured in instrumentation. Its broad incorporation of sound and instruments imitating sounds reminds me of Arl Kitsch. It's almost art for the sake of art, but with a sentimentality that draws out the good old days. If one is aware of the purpose of the placements of the sounds in this piece, one begins to appreciate its essence, despite its initial coarseness. You Never Know Who Your Friends Are, first part of Mystery Disc, but now more widely known from Frank Zappa's album Finer Moments, begins with a harmonica playing two chords back and forth over and over. There are background sounds resembling a typewriter and air entering a balloon, which stop when the kazoo enters, playing a carefree tune that may remind the listener of a drunken version of the Entry of the Gladiators theme by Julius Fusik. The kazoo is practically interrupted after a few seconds by the squeak of air being let out of a balloon. This high squeal continues to punctuate the beats, almost keeping tempo for the other parts. The kazoo continues, but eventually fades as the harmonica comes back in with full force, playing "Oh Susanna." In the meantime, the listener is surprised by the sound of air being blown over the rim of a bottle in a few seemingly random interjections, while a regular clattering, clapping sound boosts the energy of the music in time with a squeaking balloon. Soon that squeak becomes part of the accompaniment just in time for a piano to enter. The piano supports and creates a counterpart for the harmonica. At about 57 seconds, we also hear a bicycle horn honk a few times. A faint but raucous female voice, sounding much like an old lady, enthusiastically begins to sing along with the harmonica. The listener can hardly help but cringe at the obnoxious, exaggerated squawks that evoke an image of a wrinkly woman with flapping arms and clapping her hands to the beat. The piano has already taken a secondary role, and before the first minute is up, we hear an instrument imitating animals, first a peacock and then horses. A man hollers a few times in the distance, somewhat reminiscent of a circus, and the harmonica comes in with a seafaring tune. As the texture thins and accompaniment mellows, an instrument imitates the cry of a baby, which brings the imagery back to childhood. In the background, simple everyday sounds are taking place, from a garbage truck and trash cans to a cat fight. There are sticks clacking together and a momentary lack of melodic accompaniment. The harmonica's ditty picks up pace at about a minute and a half, and we hear more animal noises, mostly monkeys this time, also made with instruments. I'm unsure of any particular reference here, but this could easily be tied to the primal nature of humanity, in relation to the monkeys, anyway. This begins a transition to the closing section of the piece, where two voices, then a kazoo and balloon, begin a chorus of chuck chuck in a boom chuck chuck 3/4 pattern. if the piece had a time signature based on the previous familiar tunes incorporated, then we and which we have felt that 4/4 time up to this point, then we have now adjusted to a completely new one in the course of a few seconds. The tune of "The More We Get Together," familiar to children as a welcoming song, becomes the part of a blaring voice, then a second voice, accompanied further by the return of the blown bottle instrument. After sounding intermittently for a few moments, the balloon lets out a long squeal and settles the other noises, except for the two voices that continue the tune, but more quietly this time. The balloon continues attempts to throw out or to drown out the voices for a few moments, then gives up entirely before the sounds fade. And with that explanation as a preface, let's listen to the song, and I will help you follow along with a visual that I've created of the so-called score. Take note that the I'll show you that the harmonicas here kind of act as a baseline. These straight lines underneath the lines of the score kind of act as a baseline or accompaniment pattern for the rest of the piece. And with that, let's go ahead and get started. So I'm sure you noticed that not all of the background noise details were in this animation of the piece, but I want you to take a look at this and see how you might interpret the form. It adds instrumentation, voices increase throughout, and it's almost like an ABC. There's an ABC section here. We have an A where a first theme in a way is introduced, and we have a second theme that comes in with a completely new song about just beyond a third of the way through. And we have this major arch here where we have a sort of a lull in sound, but then an increase right before the last section of the piece that seems the most simple and possibly the most dull, but definitely brings the music to a close. By way of interpretation, the opening theme that was introduced by the harmonica, almost mimicking entry of the gladiators, could have great significance. For one thing, this main theme has been most commonly used in the circus, and it indicates a feeling of excitement, but also unsettling anticipation. If it creates an image of the circus, as perhaps it was meant to do, one can instantly see how the distrust of the title, "You Never Know Who Your Friends Are," coincides with the idea that at the surface one hardly knows what is real and what is imagined or exaggerated. We as listeners are instantly drawn into this worldview of distrust with such a strident opening musical statement. Mostly, it sounds like a child's birthday party with the balloon, the kazoo, and the clattering pulses, and familiar children and folk melodies throughout. Life, like this song, can be chaotic, and it is difficult to know what or whom to trust. This is especially true as an adult, looking back on childhood friendships. As innocent children, we could not have known what friends would be around in later years to care about and support us. And even now, how do we know? This piece is typical of Zappa in that it cross-references greater works such as Entry of the Gladiators and O Susanna, and juxtaposes higher and lower musical associations, those being prime examples. However, instead of sporting Frank's incredible improv skills or the tight harmonies of his band, he paints for us a picture of color and confusion with sounds he doesn't necessarily own himself. This possible emotional distance from the work could have harsh implications for the artist. It may have been written at a time of emotional betrayal, or perhaps it was simply an expression to which he placed a quirky yet serious name, but judging by the significance of the messages in Zappa's other compositions, this is likely no exception in having an underlying message itself. What we can tell for sure is that despite the mostly positive associations of these familiar sounds and songs, we as listeners experience a sense of conflict. For a moment, we are absorbed in a world where, whether old or young, outlaw or in-law, you never know who your friends are. And like it or not, that is a part of the world that we inhabit.